I want to talk more about our Comanche Constitution. I've mentioned some of these things before, but they bear more thought. I don't understand why so many Comanche people revere our Constitution. We've been pleased to govern ourselves by it for decades, but this is what I see. The way this Constitution is written, it allows a few people to control how our resources are spent, our financial resources. Now, as we've all read many times, Article 4, Section 1 identifies the supreme governing body shall be the Comanche Tribal Council. That's the voters over the age of 18. The Tribal Council sees to it that there is elected what is called the Comanche Business Committee. And that includes the chairman, vice chairman, secretary, treasurer, and other members, four committee members. It is tacitly understood that this Comanche Business Committee makes the decisions for the tribe. And the initiation, the initial propositions and ideas, everything comes from the CBC. Once a year, the Tribal Council meets in April, coming up soon here, next month, meet and supposedly, theoretically, discuss their ideas about what the CBC has proposed in terms of the budget for the whole tribe, what money is going to be spent on. At that meeting, the General Council is supposed to be able to say yay, nay, on every line in the budget. Of course, that never happens. But the discussion, there's no time, there's not enough time at the General Council meeting to discuss everything that needs to be discussed. So we eventually get our ballots and we vote yay or nay on each item. And we trust that these votes are counted. And when we say no on something, it's voted out. That means it's not going to be funded. But what usually happens is if it's voted out that year, it appears on the budget the next year for a higher amount of money than it required the year before when it was voted out. There's a great deal of distrust of the people, but we live with this distrust. We live with mistrust, distrust. It's a very patient people, a very forgiving people. It's amazing to watch. They can be pushed to the point where the Comanche people will stand up. We have people like Eleanor McDaniel, who is willing to make the effort to get petitions signed to remove people from office. That's the way it's the Constitution designs that we are to remedy our grievances, is we just remove people from office. I think that's a little bit, it's a hard way of doing things. But I do want to say, I am campaigning for a Comanche chairman. I disapprove of the Constitution. I have no sentimental value of it. I want progress. But this constitution has become part of Comanche tradition. I put quotes around that word tradition. So therefore, it isn't likely that it's going to be changed. But the way it's set up, it allows a continual abuse of funds, a continual breach between the people and the leaders, and we've just lived with it. That doesn't make it right, and it doesn't mean that it is the most efficient way, the best way to run things. Why do we live with it if we don't have to? Are the people reluctant to change? Apparently so. And this is why, once again, I proclaim before the world that not only Comanches, but American Indians are conservative. Conservative means to conserve, to preserve, to reserve. That's what we do. We're very conservative people in our behavior. We are politically to be identified as conservative, in my opinion. And yet, well, this is Oklahoma, and most Indians in Oklahoma are all Democrat. That was the functioning party in the beginning, and they solicited the Indian support or the Indian vote, and the few Indians that were interested became Democrat, and it is handed down to their family. My mother and her parents, they were all Democrat. My mother eventually changed to Republican, and many of my cousins have changed to Republican now. But in Oklahoma, the Indian tradition is to be Democrat, and that's without understanding anything about what Democrats believe in and want and what their sinister designs are on this country. But my point is, Indians are conservative by nature, and therefore it shall be difficult to change our Comanche Constitution. It shall be difficult to improve our tribal government.